हस्तानि सहस्तानाम् अपदानि च तुष्पदाम् फल्गुणि तत्र महताम् जीवो जीवस्य जीवनम्। द श्लोक वॉज स्पोकन बाय नारद मुनि टू युधिष्ठिर महाराज। ही सेज दैट अहस्तानि सहस्तानाम् मीन्स दोज लिविंग एंटिटीज दैट डू नॉट हैव हैंड्स बिकम फूड फॉर दोज लिविंग एंटिटीज दैट हैव हैंड्स। अपदानि चतुष्पदाम् those living entities that do not have legs will become food for those living entities who have four legs. So in this way, in this material world, one living being will become food for another living being. This is called the law of sustenance. One living entity survives by depending on other living entities, right? Falguni tatra mahatam means a stronger living being survives on a weaker living being, means a weaker living being becomes food for a stronger living being. This is the law of nature. Jivo jivasya jivanam, one jiva is dependent on another jiva for one's own sustenance. This is a simple fact which is very much current in this entire material creation. This is what Narada Muni speaks to Yudhishthira Maharaj in the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. How do we understand this? For example, a weaker living being, for example, a deer is there, it becomes a food for a tiger. Tiger is a very strong living being. When a tiger goes and kills the deer, it's quite natural because the tiger has to live. For that, the tiger needs some flesh of some younger, lower living beings. So, tiger can kill a deer and then eat it. So, there's nothing to be lamented when a cruel animal like a tiger or a lion kills some lower living beings or weaker living beings. But when it comes to human life, a human life is not meant to live a life like this. There is a law of sustenance, there is also a law of common sense. So just because a stronger living being can subsist on weaker living being, that does not become a license for a stronger human being to exploit the weaker human beings. So Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, in the 9th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, 26th shloka, Krishna says, Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayachati tadaham bhakti pahritam ashnami prayatatmanah. Now a human being is supposed to eat food after offering that food to God. Because whatever we get only by the blessings of the Supreme Lord. So we are supposed to first offer that food to the Lord and then eat that food. By that, we will be relieved from the sinful reaction. Animals cannot follow this. Animals cannot follow the injunctions of scriptures or the instructions of a spiritual master or guru. So animals just act according to their own impulses, their own sensual demands. But a human being is supposed to regulate those sensual demands according to the instructions of the scriptures. So, although one jiva is dependent on another jiva for one's sustenance, that does not mean a human being kills like weaker animals and sustains upon them. So, a human being, the prescribed food for a human being in the scriptures, especially in Bhagavad Gita, is that a human being eats some fruits and milk and then vegetables and roots and this kind of things. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayachati. Patram means leaf, pushpam means flower, phalam means fruit, toyam means water. So these four kinds of items can be offered to Krishna. So a living entity, a human being, is supposed to offer the food to the Supreme Lord Krishna before eating it oneself. So, and what can be offered to Krishna? Patram pushpam phalam toyam. So, this is what Srila Prabhupada says in this purport of this beautiful shloka. So, jivo jivasya jivanam. So, one living entity depends on another living entity for one's sustenance. But a human being is supposed to regulate one's activities, eating activities or living habits according to the prescriptions of the scriptures. So, one should not, just because a human being is very strong, that's not a license for that stronger human being to unnecessarily exploit weaker living entities or weaker human beings. So that is acting against the scriptural injunctions. So one should be very careful, but one should understand the law of sustenance, because non-human beings just follow this path. Right? Non-human beings, if a tiger kills a deer and eats the flesh of the deer, the tiger may not incur any sinful reaction, because tiger does not follow any scriptures. But a human being, when he does the same thing and kills weaker living beings and eats, he is obliged to experience the reaction that comes from such an action, that's from such a cruel action. So this is what scriptures teaches. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
For more such devotional programs, please watch Hare Krishna Television. To get this channel, please contact your cable or DTH operator. For more information, please call 8767-845-845.